Chod Kutta Kameena, how does it feel to know that you failed? Huh? And I'm not just saying that because I'm broadcasting from an undisclosed location where you can't find me. No, I'm saying this because everyone feels this way. Everyone knows that we're coming for you and you are going to fucking lose. How does it feel to know that karma's a bitch and payback is coming? I can't wait to see you brought down. The time has come and the time is now. I'm saying this, but I'm gonna say it here loud and proud to you listeners. Bugun's reign of terror is over. The fat lady has sung. This feels weird. I mean, I've been waiting for this day for so long. I can't tell you how many years it's been. I've lost count. But I gotta say it here loud and proud on the air for all of you guys to hear. The Golden Bath is victorious by your hero. You guys, and much of this, I cannot exclude this guy, much of it is due to the hard work and effort of my man, Ajay Gali, brother, Bhaijaan. The next time we meet, I want to thank you personally. Mere bhai, thank you so much. You finished your father's work, and he is so proud of you, and we're all so proud of you. Kira owes you a great debt. are, you guys. Victory is basically here, and that's a good thing. But what are we gonna do about all the guns out there? Sure, we needed guns during the war, but do we want so many guns around while we're rebuilding? I've gotten used to seeing guns everywhere. It's weird when I don't see a gun. Is it me, or are you also eating dinner with the safety off? Because I don't know if that's a good way to live. One thing's for sure, if a zombie apocalypse... ever was to break out, get it? We're in good shape. We would fuck up some zombies. In the animal population recently? Okay, I mean, it seems to me like there are a lot less of the little critters running around. Maybe it's just me, but I get the impression that someone's been doing a lot of hunting. I'm serious. What the hell are these people killing all these animals for? I mean, we're all vegetarian here. It's not for food. There's no way you're just eating tiger burgers every day. That's a lot of fucking tiger burgers to eat. You need to diversify. At least have some vegetables. Someone's making a line of designer wallets and handbags using the local wildlife. Now that's an interesting business idea. Oh, yeah. That's gotta be it. Oh, yep, okay. Yes, I already see it right now. Somebody's killing all these animals, then making a super exclusive line of wildlife-based clothing and accessories. I already have it in my...
My family, and now they're dead because of him.
What's happened? Can I help?
Yes. Send him into the...
Come on there! Show yourself!
Ah. Your business is appreciated.
To over this shit! Good. Go.
What did I do to this man?
I'm not afraid to die.
So look, just go. Go. Go, go!
Thank you.
know what I just realized, you guys? We gotta have a party up in here. I'm serious. Get up. It's free. I want my loyal listeners coming down to where we are. Somebody bring the booze. Somebody bring the fireworks. And somebody please bring me some fucking bacon. Because, man, let the good times roll. I mean, sure, yes, we have our problems. We have some things that we need to take care of. I mean, yes, we have abandoned cars. We have animal carcasses. Drugs are still a problem. General infrastructure still needs to be rebuilt. And, yes, there are animals running rampant. But that's fine. We can take care of that stuff after the party. You know what would actually be kind of weird? What if those animals started picking up all the guns and ammo and then turned on the humans? That would be fucking crazy. That would be such a cool movie. I mean, can you imagine a honey badger holding you up with an assault rifle in his hand? That's a great movie. And I would pay to go see that movie. That's a fucking really good movie called Honey Badgers Gone Wild. But then it's not like one of those movies where they strip it, but honey badgers killing human beings. And I swear, I haven't been doing any drugs yet. This is just me thinking off the top of the dome. I'm not doing any drugs until after you guys bring it over here. Then we can get on some crazy trips and we can talk about this stuff. But I think that's pretty crazy. Actually, you know what? Let's just get back to music. Noticed a decrease in the animal population recently? Okay, I mean, it seems to me like there are a lot less of the little critters running around. Maybe it's just me, but I get the impression that someone's been doing a lot of hunting. I'm serious. What the hell are these people killing all these animals? Noticed a decrease in the animal population recently? Okay, I mean, it seems to me like there are a lot less of the little critters running around. Maybe it's just me, but I get the impression that someone's been doing a lot of hunting. I'm serious. What the hell are these people killing all these animals for? I mean, we're all vegetarian here. It's not for food. There's no way you're just eating tiger burgers every day. That's a lot of fucking tiger burgers to eat. You need to diversify. At least have some vegetables. It'll make your bowel movements a lot smoother. Maybe someone's making a line of designer wallets and handbags using the local wildlife. Now that's an interesting business idea. Oh, yeah. That's gotta be it. Oh, yep, okay. Yes, I already see it right now. Somebody's killing all these animals, then making a super exclusive line of wildlife-based clothing and accessories. I already have it imagined. It's called...
Fix cars.
Hey, over here. Thank you. I owe you so much more. About all the guns out there. Sure, we needed guns during the war, but do we want so many guns around while we're rebuilding? I mean, I've gotten used to seeing guns everywhere. It's weird when I don't see a gun. Is it me, or are you also eating dinner with the safety off? Because I don't know if that's a good way to live. One thing's for sure, if a zombie apocalypse ever was to break out, Kirat, we're in good shape. We would fuck up some zombies.
The yoke of my plow spit in half, and there's no wood to fix it. The army.
Namaste.
Private Vora is supposed to be supervising a shipment soon. Down this road, I think. Be difficult, but we could catch him off guard.
I'm not a bad shot.
Yeah, well, I hear you're a very good shot. I'm not Boris intended.
Here we are live, we are on the air, and the day is finally here. Man, I can't believe I'm saying this, but I'm gonna say it here loud and proud to you listeners. Bugun's reign of terror is over. The fat lady has sung.
Ivan Vora is supposed to be supervising a shipment soon.
I'm not a bad shot.
About all the guns out there. Sure, we needed guns during the war, but do we want so many guns around while we're rebuilding? I mean, I've gotten used to seeing guns everywhere. It's weird when I don't see a gun. Is it me, or are you also eating dinner with the safety off? Because I don't know if that's a good way to live. One thing's for sure, if a zombie apocalypse ever...
Do you have a minute? Thank you so much.
General infrastructure still needs to be rebuilt, and yes, there are animals running rampant, but that's fine. We can take care of that stuff.
I never thought you would survive this long. You're doing nicely.